This is a Manta Sports Media presentation of 2A football action. Happy Friday to you, and being Friday and here in the Bluegrass, that can only mean one thing, and that is Friday Night Lights here at the Hill at Olive Hill. Welcome to Blankenship Field here for tonight's matchup between the Comets and the Wildcats. And so this should be a good matchup here this evening as we have the number one ranked, according to the RPI, in District 8, currently ranked number six in the Class 2A District 8. And, of course, if we take a look at the overall rankings, Wes Carter this evening is coming in at number 10 statewide across 2A, and Bath County's coming in at number 31 in Class 2A football. And so this should be a great game this afternoon as Wes Carter looking to continue on their winning streak from last week's defeat of Shelby Valley, as they defeated the Wildcats of Shelby Valley 26-20, and a thriller that went all the way down to the fourth quarter. Of course, a great game, and you can see those stats from the Comets for last week's matchup brought to you up by James Do It Best Hardware and by Justin Criswell, attorney at law. And so, as we said, this should be a good game here tonight because we do have the Comets of Wes Carter in the 2A District 8, 3-2 on the season. And having a little bit of ups and downs, a couple downs, but mostly they're finding out their rhythm and everything else and getting onto a roll because last year, of course, they were purely a rushing team. They could definitely throw the ball when they need to, and that kind of helped open up that running lane. But this year they're primarily known for their passing with a little bit of running in there as well, so their passing is opening up the running as well. And, of course, they're going to be taking on the Bath County Wildcats. They're in 2A and currently 3-3 overall on the season. Two of those games were COVID cancelizations. They picked up one win from it, one loss from it, and so they are coming in as far as games played, 2-2 on the season, but the official record is 3-3. And so we'll take a look up at our matchups here this afternoon, or this evening, excuse me. We've got our head-to-head matchup here for passing. Of course, Jacob Easton going to be the quarterback for the Wildcats. He is 28 of 81 on the season, passing for 377 yards, two touchdowns, and five interceptions. And so that is his season stats so far. And then taking a look here at Eli Estep from Wes Carter. He's just about 50% on his passing, but he's gotten 661 yards on the season, seven touchdowns with four interceptions. And so he's only had two games with interceptions, one being Round County and the other one being with Raceland, where he had two apiece on that night. And so there's your quarterback head-to-head matchup here tonight. Now we'll take a look at rushing, in which, of course, Bath County not typically known ball 76 times of Quentin Lewis, their leading rusher. He's picked up 543 yards on the season with 11 touchdowns, and he is on per attempt, he is averaging 7.1 yards per carry. Cole Crampton, the leading rusher for Wes Carter, has 108 attempts on the year with 490 yards, four touchdowns, and he averages out 4.5 yards per carry. And so there's your matchup between the leading rushers for the Comets and the Wildcats. And, of course, if we take a look at some stat leaders, of course, we're a little bit early here tonight. Of course, a couple different activities that'll be going on. Of course, it is JFL night here at Wes Carter here tonight. And so they'll be honoring those JFL players here as well. But if we take a look at the 2A stat leaders, of course, Bath County not on the record. There's a couple stats that have not been turned in, and which it's kind of knocked them out of this report. So we can't report on them. But if we take a look, Cole Crampton is number 12 in rushing so far this season. Like we said, he averages 4.5 yards per an attempt, and he averages about 98 yards per game. And so Cole Crampton's starting to get his feet underneath him and starting to learn a little bit how it is to be the lead rusher for this Wes Carter offense. And then, of course, taking a look as well as far as passing. Then you have Eli Estep, number 9 in 2A football. As we mentioned before, he's got 7 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, and he averages 132 yards per game. And, of course, his completion percentage is 48.2%. So he's nearing 50% on the season. As far as receiving goes, of course, Wes Carter trying to get in on that list there and make it on number 27 as Blake McClone is out there as well for the season. And or he's not out for the season, but he's on this list right now. He's got 16 receptions for 187 yards, and he has got 11.7 yards per reception and 2 touchdowns underneath his name. Of course, I'm sure that probably soon to be on that list will be Jackson Bond, as he picked up a huge 93-yard pass from Estep last week. And they had a fantastic ball game that day against a very tough Shelby Valley Wildcat team. And then, of course, as far as scoring goes, Cole Crampton ranks in at number 30 across 2A. He averages out 7.6 points per game, so averages about a touchdown for each of the games he's been there. And then, of course, looking as well across some of the other stats and everything else, Connor Green, the number 8 tackler in 2A football, averages about 10.2 tackles per game, and he's got 4 tackles for a loss this season. And then, of course, Sam Jones making it on the list at number 25, averages 7.6 tackles per game, 4 tackles per loss, or tackles for a loss as well. And then, of course, taking a look down the way, Sam Rayburn, he is the number 14th in defensive sacks. He's got 3 on the season. And then Sam Jones also number 3 in forced fumbles. He averages, he's, or not averages, but in 5 games, he has forced 3 fumbles, and he has picked up 1 himself.
Welcome to and now
we'll turn it over here to the announcer here at Wes Carter.
For tonight's football,
Chris Perry doing the PA here for the Comets.
Features the visiting Wildcats of Bath County taking on your Wes Carter.
As we see the band and the ROTC there, but they're going to be having a moment of silence here
before we start
for Jim Matney, the Johnson County head coach that recently passed away. Johnson Central, I should say, instead of Johnson County, but Johnson Central head coach Jim Matney.
Please join the Wes Carter family in remembering Coach Manning's family and players, along with the Johnson Central community in your thoughts and prayers over the days and weeks to come. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of the colors and the playing of our national anthem. The cadets would like to remind all in attendance that removal of hats and placing your right hand over your heart during the playing of the national anthem is the proper courtesy during this presentation. The colors are presented this evening by the Wes Carter High School Junior ROTC Color Guard. Carrying the United States flag is Cadet Captain Kenny Simmerly. Carrying the Commonwealth of Kentucky flag is Cadet Captain Shelby Russell. The rifle bearers are Cadets Lieutenants Christopher Fannin and Shelby Jordan. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing until the colors have exited the playing field.
And the colors presented by the Wes Carter High School Junior ROTC program underneath the direction of Colonel Hilton.
J.L. Hilton.
And the national anthem playing tonight by the members of the Wes Carter High School Marching Band underneath the direction of J.L. Hilton. And so now the band exiting the field, getting ready to start up the pep line toward the Wes Carter High School tunnel. Of course, the Johnson Central head coach announced earlier on this week of his passing. Of course, you know, a huge loss here in the Eastern Kentucky area, as he was a longtime coach of Johnson Central. He will be missed by several. And, of course, earlier on in the week, several football stadiums lighting up their lights at 7:30 in honor of the late coach, and including even the University of Kentucky. They were in on that as well. And so they lit up their field at 7:30 game time in honor of the coach. And so our thoughts and prayers are with the Johnson Central Eagle family, as well as the Matney family. And so as we got about 5 minutes left, we'll take a brief commercial break here, and we'll be back momentarily. You're watching 2-8 Football live here on Mantis Sports Media.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District, and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
And back here once again at Wes Carter, as the Comets getting ready to come out here on the field. The cheerleaders and the JFL players all making the pep line this evening here on the field. And so we're just moments away here from the Comets entering in. So the Comets, of course, having this week no school this week for fall break. And, of course, the last day of fall break today for the faculty, staff, and the students here of Carter County Schools. And so this gave the Comets some important workout time this week, as here comes the Comets. 3-2 on the season. And then, of course, cross field, we got the Bath County Wildcats still stretching it out here this evening. But we'll take a couple more commercial breaks, and we'll be back here momentarily for some 2A football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky. Phone number 606-286-2692.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606 847-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at chriswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell. For the area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
The next time you are in Mount Sterling, take the short drive out to Cecilia's Country Market at 4100 Maysville Road for some good home cooking, one of the area's best breakfast, and daily lunch specials, all at affordable prices. Competitive gas and diesel prices, with the little items we all need every day, all in one place. Open from 8 a.m. until 7 p.m. That's Cecilia's Country Market, 4100 Maysville Road, Mount Sterling, Kentucky, right next to the world-famous Judy Drive-In.
As time goes by, don't forget to capture the moments that will create memories that will last a lifetime with Eastern Wing Photography. No matter the occasion, we have you covered. If you need family portraits, engagement photos, prom pictures, senior photos, sports photos, baby pictures, and wedding photos, we are ready to work for you. You can find us online on Facebook or contact us at 606-286-0991 or at easternlinkphotography@yahoo.com to schedule a photo session.
All righty, Wes Carter has won the coin toss and has elected to defer to the second half. And so we are moments away here from kickoff here this evening. Of course, number 33, Isaac Bond, will be kicking it away for Wes Carter. Looks like number 22, Hunter McCoy. And number one, Jordan Everman, back to receive for Bath County. So Wes Carter in the maroon uniforms with maroon tops and bottoms, gray helmets, the Bath County Wildcats in the white helmets, white jerseys, and red pants.
Isaac Bond.
So Isaac Bond getting ready to kick it off underway here to get this District 8 matchup underway. And that's just going to be a fair catch called, and so Bath County will be taking over.
Fair catch by number four, Cameron Allen, for the
number four,
Wildcats.
Cameron Allen on the reception for Bath County. And that was going to put it right near the 31-yard line.
The first and 10 for the Wildcats from the 31-yard line.
So Bath County first and 10 from their own 31-yard line. Running the wishbone formation. I know I've seen some other schools do this earlier. And he's going to pick up a couple yards on the play. A lot of teams running that wishbone in honor of the Johnson Centrals coach, as that was his format that they usually run. And so that's going to be a 3-yard pickup for Bath County.
34-yard line.
So second and 7 here for Bath County. Hands it off again. And he's going to fight for some extra yards, getting it close to the 40-yard line, as that was Quentin Lewis for Bath County. It's still going to be third down and looks like about 2.
Ball's carried by number 24, Quentin Lewis. Brought down by the Comets, number 33, Isaac Bond.
Isaac Bond on the tackle for Wes Carter.
And about 4 yards on the play, brings up third and 3 from the Wildcat 39.
Bath County handing it off to Lewis once again. And he is going to be close to a first down, and they are going to give it to him as he crosses right over to about the 41-yard line.
Carried by Lewis again.
And so that'll be first and 10 here for Bath County now on their own 41-yard line.
Brought down by West Carter's number 34, Connor Green.
Green on the tackle for West Carter.
At 41.
And this time he's going to maybe pick up a yard as, let's see who that is.
Handoff was to
number 11, Carter Hart, on the carry. Gets close back, maybe picked up about a foot on the play. And so it'll be about second and 10, or we'll call it second and 9 here. Didn't get a full yard, but got it to about the 42-yard line. Pitches it out to Lewis this time. And Lewis going to be wrapped up by Isaac Bond of West Carter. And that's going to be bringing up third down as he picked up maybe a yard on the play.
Gain of about 2 yards.
And so that'll be third and 8 here for Bath County.
Brings up third and 8 from the Wildcat 43.
And we'll get our time corrected here. And this time, dropping back to pass, but being chased down by West Carter. So number 34 and 16, Sam Jones and Connor Green on the tackle there, kept by Derek Butcher.
Jacob Easton.
Or excuse me. Jacob Easton, it was number 6, on there. And so that's going to be bringing up.
Yards on the play. Brings up
a loss of 5, and so that'll be fourth down and 13 here for the Wildcats. So Bath County now set back to punt. Jackson Bond on the reception back for West Carter. And that one may have gotten a little bit of a piece kick to it, and that sails out of bounds. And so they're going to mark it right around the 47-yard line of West Carter. So it will be first and 10 for the Comets on their own 47-yard line. So West Carter in with some good field position to start out. Actually, they bump it up a yard, and it's about the 48-yard line. So West Carter spreading it out, three wide receivers on the right, on the far side, one on the near side. Estep fakes it off and tries to get it to McGlone across the middle of the field, but that's going to be an incomplete pass, and it'll be Estep's second down and 10.
Bond, incomplete, brings up second and 10.
So it'll be second down and 10 on the incomplete pass by West Carter. This time, spreading out the field equally, two on the far side, two on the near side. Crampton in the backfield with Estep, and this time they're going to hand it off to Crampton. And he's got some running room as he has broken some tackles. He's got one man to meet, and he is finally brought down right around the 13-yard line of West Carter. So a huge run there. Was on the 48, so down on the 13. Huge gain there for Connor Green. And so that'll be first and 10 for West Carter on their own 13-yard line. And they're going to hand it off to Cole Crampton again. I think I said Connor Green, but it was Cole Crampton on the run. And Crampton carries it in again, picks up about, looks like 8, and it'll be second down and 2 for the Comets.
Takes it to the Bath County 6-yard line, second and 3rd.
All right, they're going to say second down and 3 here for a 7-yard gain by Crampton. West Carter spreading out the field once again. And they're going to hand it off to Crampton again as he shuffles over, spins around, and he is in for the touchdown. So Wes Carter strikes first blood and gets the touchdown here this evening off of the Cole Crampton run. It was a six-yard run in for six, and Wes Carter is on the board early here with 7 minutes and 18 seconds left to play here in the first quarter. Wes Carter leads 6-0. And we'll see what Wes Carter decides to do here. And looks like Estep's going to be back to kick here for the Comets. And the kick is up. And that one's going to split the uprights, and that is good. So after the Comets' first possession, they get a touchdown off of a six-yard run by Cole Crampton. So we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region and 2A football live here on the Banta Sports Media Network.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Come visit Stylish Stitches at our new home at 730 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard in Olive Hill, Kentucky, now with the Red Door Boutique, for the best in customized gifts and fashion, as well as local sports team merchandise. From the runway to game day, we have you covered.
All righty, and we're back here at Blankenship Field here in Olive Hill, where Wes Carter only throwing it once with an incomplete pass and gave it to Cole Crampton the rest of the way for the Comet touchdown, and then extra point by Estep. And this is going to sail right to right around the 31-yard line. I think that's where they started at last time. Reception made by Cameron Allen, but ran out of bounds. And so it will be first and 10 for the Wildcats once again on their own 31-yard line.
Cameron Allen with the catch. Stepped out of bounds.
So last possession by the Wildcats resulted in a punt after picking up a first down. This time Bath County spreading the field a little bit more. Two on the near side, two on the far side. And fakes the pass, turns around, and he's still looking downfield but going to hold on to it. Sam Jones, first one to get to him, and he's going to pick up about a yard on the play on the quarterback keeper. And so that was Jacob Easton.
By Connor Green.
Sam Jones, Connor Green, both in there
on the play.
For the Comets.
Second and eight.
So it'll be second down and eight here for Bath County. So they're going to give him 2 yards on the run. Spreading out the field once again. This time hands it off to number 11. And we got a flag down on the play. So that handoff was to Carter Hart of Bath County, and that came in from the backside. And it's going to be holding against the Wildcats.
Holding call against Bath County.
So that's going to be a spot foul, which it was about near the line. The original line scrimmage, and so it gets bumped back to right around the looks like the 23-yard line.
Brings up second and 18.
So it'll be still second down and 18 as a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. This time, dropping back to pass, but flag on the play. And incomplete pass as he was looking for Jordan Everman.
Easton
was looking for Everman on the side.
Got a flag on the play.
And looks like an ineligible receiver for the Wildcats.
An eligible receiver downfield.
And so that's going to
brings up third down.
Be a loss of down. No additional yardage. or the penalty was declined since the Comets declined the penalty, and so it'll be third and 18.
Third and 18 from the Wildcat 23.
So ultimately just a loss of down there for the Wildcats, not pushing them back any further, because it would have been second down and even further. And this time he connects to his man right in the middle of the field, number 12, Derek Butcher.
Easton's pass intended for Butcher's complete.
And so that's going to be bringing up fourth down, and let's see where they put it at. It's going to be fourth down and about five for Bath County off of the 13-yard pass from Easton to Butcher. And so it looks like Bath County is back in punting formation once again for Bath County.
Jackson Bond back to receive.
And low punt or low snap. And that punt takes a roll. Jackson Bond is going to pick it up and ends up maybe losing a yard or two on the reception. But holds on to the ball, and so it will be Wes Carter's ball with 5:08 here left to go in the first quarter.
On the Comets 32.
So Wes Carter
first and 10
on their own 32-yard line here tonight. So in the last possession by the Comets, they mainly kept it on the ground, ran it by through with Crampton, and ended up giving him a touchdown off of a 6-yard run. So Wes Carter spreading the field out again. Two on the far side, two on the near. Single back and in the shotgun. Hands it off to Crampton again. And he has got a hole there. And he's finally going to be brought down right around the 28-yard line. And so huge gain Crampton once again by Cole Crampton. And so it'll be first and 10 for the Comets.
Brings up first and 10.
I think they said it was a 38-yard run by Crampton. As Bath County letting him slide right by there and only had one man left to beat. And we're going to get a timeout taken by here by the Bath County Wildcats. So we'll be back here in 60 seconds here on Mantis Sports Media.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky. Phone number 606-286-2692. If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029. Or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell.
Back here at Wes Carter, where it's first and 10 for the Comets on the Bath County 28-yard line. Bath County taking a timeout. Man in motion for Wes Carter. And this time they're going to air it out down the field. And that is going to be good for another Comet touchdown, as that's going to be a 28-yard pass to Jackson Bond. So he stepped to Bond, 28-yard pass, and Wes Carter has picked up another touchdown here in the first quarter. And now it is 13-0 here. Wes Carter on top, getting it done in the air and on the ground here this evening.
He steps out to attempt the extra point.
So with 4 minutes, 40 seconds left to play here in the first quarter, Wes Carter up by a 2-touchdown lead. He steps kick, that is up, and that is good. So it's 14-0, Wes Carter on the lead And we'll be back here in 60 seconds here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
The next time you are in Mount Sterling, take the short drive out to Cecilia's Country Market at 4100 Maysville Road for some good home cooking, one of the area's best breakfast, and daily lunch specials, all at affordable prices. Competitive gas and diesel prices, with the little items we all need every day, all in one place. Open from 8 a.m. until 7 p.m. That's Cecilia's Country Market, 4100 Maysville Road, Mount Sterling, Kentucky, right next to the world-famous Judy Drive-In.
And here's the kickoff for Bond on the kickoff, and this time a little bit more progress as that one was taken by number four, Cameron Allen. And so they are going to be taking over on their own 45-yard line.
The first and 10 for the Wildcats from their own 45-yard line.
So Bath County's had two possessions and had to punt it away twice. And hands it off to number 11. As he tries to put it right up the gut, and he's going to pick up a couple yards on the play. So that was Carter Hart on the carry for Bath County, and it'll be second down and 8 here for the Wildcats.
Gain of about 2 yards. It brings up second and 8 from the Wildcat 47.
So far, Bath County has not been in West Carter territory yet, but they're knocking at the door right here. As they are 3 yards away from breaking into West Carter territory for the first time here tonight. And this time hands it off to number 24, and he's got a little bit of breathing room as he breaks into West Carter territory, and he is going to be in for the 6, and that is a touchdown, Bath County. So that is Quentin Lewis gets his 12th touchdown of the year and wastes no time trying to get Bath County on the board. And so it is now West Carter 14, Bath County 6. So a huge run there by Quentin. Losing my name here. We'll get her out here in just a moment. 24, Quentin Lewis.
Attempt the extra point.
As that was a 55-yard run by Quentin Lewis. And so Bath County looking like they're setting up for the extra point here. Jacob Easton will be holding. And the kick is up. And it is good.
Extra point.
So it looks like that was number
Bath County 7.
Trying to figure out who the kicker on that might be, Bryson Stigall.
In our JFL and middle school programs. That's
on the extra point for Bath County. And so we'll be back here momentarily. You are watching 2A football live here on Mantis Sports Media.
The area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
And so off of the 45-yard, and we'll get that graphic off there, off the 45-yard run there by Quentin Lewis, Bath County has cut the lead in half. And so typically most West Carter games this year has been defensive battles, but so far we've seen the fireworks happening quick and often by both teams here. As we are in a 14-7 game here, still in the first quarter with 3:43 left to play. Jackson Bond, I believe Crampton on the reception or back to receive here for Wes Carter. And that's going to be a fair catch taken there by, I think that's Sam Jones. And so Wes Carter will be starting off Sam on Jones their own 39-yard line.
Brings up a first and 10, Wes Carter.
So it'll be first down and 10 for the Comets on their own 39-yard line.
Comets are on their own 40-yard line. Correction, 39-yard line.
So we've seen Wes Carter getting a job done on the ground and in the air here tonight. So been mixing it up. From the shotgun, they're going to hand it off to Crampton again. Flag down on the play as he makes it right around the 44-yard line.
Got a flag on the play.
And it's going to be a chop block against the Comets, and so this one's going to be coming back.
Block against, below the waist against the Comets.
And that will be a 15-yard penalty. So it will be
a 15-yard penalty.
First down and 25 here for Wes Carter.
Second and first and 25, I'm sorry. From the Comet 24-yard line.
And this time, Estep looking to air it out and hits his connection to Bond. And so that will be a Wes Carter first down as he gets about, I think about 28-yard pass from Estep to Jackson Bond. Of course, Jackson Bond during the last game against Shelby Valley broke the school record in reception.
For the Comets.
And so he's just tacking more onto it here this evening. Two on the left, two on the right. They're going to fake it to Crampton, get it across the middle to McGlone. And he's going to pick up 11 on the play, and that will be another Wes Carter first down. So on back-to-back passes, Wes Carter has hit Bond and Blake McGlone and has gained about 39 yards. So far here during this drive. Passes again, and this time it is incomplete as he was trying to hit Blake McGlone once again.
McGlone is incomplete.
So that's going to be bringing second down for Wes Carter.
From their own 36-yard line.
3:03 left to play here in the first quarter. But Wes Carter moves up to the line, still spreading out the field. Two on the far side, two on the near side. Hands it off to Crampton once again. And here he is on the near side, and he gets a block, and he's going to run it in. And he is going to get it right near the goal line. I think he's going to get it to about the 6-yard line.
Brings up another first and 10.
So it'll be first and 10 here for the Comets on their own 6-yard line.
That first down.
Crampton once again on about a 28-yard rush for Wes Carter. And so Wes Carter's now back in the red zone once again.
30-yard gain for Crampton.
Well, Wes Carter's in this situation last time. They handed it off to Crampton for the 6-yard gain. And they do it again. As he's going to be caught just short.
Crampton on the carry. We've got a flag on the play.
So flag down as this is going to be a personal foul against the Wildcats. So that's going to be about personal half the distance to the goal.
Against the Wildcats.
So it was on the 1 yard line.
Brought to you by Hamilton Law Group.
And so they'll have it on the half yard line here.
Comments are on their own 1 yard or on the Bath County 1 yard line.
West Carter spreading out the field once again, two on the far side, two on the near. Hands this off to Crampton, and he is in for a touchdown. Sorry about the extreme zoom there. Got a little heavy with that, but that's going to be a West Carter touchdown as they've gotten two rushing touchdowns and one receiving touchdown here in the first quarter.
Eastep out to attempt the extra point.
So 2 minutes and 2 seconds left to go here. Eastep will be going on the field here for the extra point. And the kick is up, and that one is going to be off of the upright and in. So that is going to count. He hit that left upright, and it must have bounced right inside of it after that. And so Wes Carter with another rushing touchdown with 2:02 left to play in the first quarter. Your score is Wes Carter 21, Bath County 7. We'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 2A Football live here on Mantis Sports Media.
Next time you are in Mount Sterling, take the short drive out to Cecilia's Country Market at 4100 Maysville Road for some good home cooking, one of the area's best breakfast, and daily lunch specials, all at affordable prices. Competitive gas and diesel prices, with the little items we all need every day, all in one place. Open from 8 a.m. until 7 p.m. That's Cecilia's Country Market, 4100 Maysville Road, Mount Sterling, Kentucky, right next to the world-famous Judy Drive-In.
And we're back here at Blankenship Field here at West Carter, where it is 21-7. And this has been the night of long plays by both teams. West Carter has gotten down to the 6 yard line twice off of a long rush and has punched it in from there. Took one play on the first one, two plays on the second one, and Bond kicks this one off. Number 14 receiving that for Bath County. And he's crossing directions here on the field. And he's got a little bit of room. Of course, there's a flag down on the play.
Got a flag on the play.
So good return there by number 14, Zachary Otis.
Otis with the carry brought down by number 4, Neil Lusher.
Lusher on the tackle for Wes Carter. And we'll see.
We do have a flag.
So this is going to be block in the back by Bath County. That's going to be declined. And then personal foul against Bath County. And so it'll be first down. So they're going to be back 15
personal
yards.
Bath County.
So that's going to push the they were into Comet territory, but after the personal foul, they are backed all the way back to the 28-yard line.
Brings up a first and 10 for the Wildcats from their own 28-yard line.
So Bath County spreading it out a little bit. Three on the far side, one on the near, but hands this off as he's wrapped up by several Comets.
Lewis on the carry.
And that was Lewis on the carry, number 24. And he picks up about one.
Tackle to Brent King.
So that'll be second down and Actually, he lost about a yard, what it looks like. So it's going to be second down and 11.
Second and 11 from the Wildcat 28.
So looking to pass this time, gets his man right across the middle, turns, and he had some open field, and he's going to get a first down. As that was to Jack Wilson. And so Jacob Easton's pass to Wilson gets him a first down right around the 40-yard line. So just about a minute left to play here in the first quarter. Bath County gets a passing first down. This time dropping back, Easton's dropping back to pass again. He's going to tuck it underneath, and he's going to be wrapped up and brought down right around the 43-yard line.
Easton with the keeper.
So that'll be second down and about seven here for Bath County.
Yards brings up second and seven from their own, from the Wildcat 43.
So just about right in front of us. No flag on the play. I'm going to get rid of that. Sorry about that. So three wide receivers on the near side. And he's going to be dropped for a loss, as that is going to be it for the first quarter. And what a quarter it has been. And so Jacob Easton on the quarterback keeper ends up losing about three on the play, and it'll be third down and 10 for Bath County after we come back in from the second quarter. So your score at the end of one is West Carter 21, Bath County 7. We'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region and 2A football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
The next time you are in Mount Sterling, take the short drive out to Cecilia's Country Market at 4100 Maysville Road for some good home cooking, one of the area's best breakfast, and daily lunch specials, all at affordable prices. Competitive gas and diesel prices, with the little items we all need every day, all in one place. Open from 8 a.m. until 7 p.m., that's Cecilia's Country Market, 4100 Maysville Road, Mount Sterling, Kentucky, right next to the world-famous Judy Drive-In.
All righty, we're here back again at West Carter, where it is 21-7. West Carter with the lead. Bath County facing a third and 10. Easton's dropping back. Another flag on the play. He's got a first down, but this one's probably going to be coming back as it gets to about the 45-yard line of West Carter. But the flag's way back here in the backfield. And so this is going to be holding against Bath County.
Holding call against the Wildcats.
So that'll be third down, but that's a 10-yard spot foul. So this is going to back them up quite a few yards as they need to make it to about the 50. And they put it right on about the 21-yard line, so it's going to be third down and about 29.
Ball is placed on the Wildcat 22.
Or it'll be 28, excuse me.
Third and 28 for the Wildcats.
And so Easton looking to pass this time. Gets his man as he's still on his feet. Crosses direction once again, and he's going to be brought down right around the 38-yard line as he connected to number 22, Hunter McCoy.
Hunter McCoy on the carry.
And so that's going to be bringing up fourth down and probably about 12 out there. So picked up about 16 on the play, but just a little bit too short there for Bath County.
A fourth and 13.
So Bath County back to punt again with Jackson Bond set to receive here for the Comets.
Kick to punt the ball.
There's the punt. Flag down on the play. And the Comets are going to let this one roll on down to about the 25-yard line. There is a flag down on the play. And this is going to be a false start against the Wildcats, but that penalty is going to be declined.
It is declined.
And so Wes Carter will be taking over on their own 25-yard line.
Take over on their own 25. It'll be first and 10, Wes Carter.
So penalties definitely plaguing the Wildcats here this evening. So with 10:26 left to play in the half, Wes Carter still leads 21-7. Spreading the field out once again. Two on the far side, two on the near. Single back and in the shotgun. E-Step gets a snap, fakes the handoff, and this time gets it to Blake McGlone as he is off to the races. Cuts back, and he is going to be in for six, and that is going to be another touchdown by Wes Carter. 75 yards to the house is E-Step to Blake McGlone. And so that is another huge play there by the Comets, and the fireworks definitely on tap here tonight. The shortest place for touchdown has been by 6 yards and about half a yard. But every other touchdown after that has been greater than 20 or 30 yards. So E-Step on tap to kick the extra point. McGlone will hold for him. So he just got a touchdown. Now he's going to be holding here for the extra point. Last time, E-Step did hit it off the crossbar and luckily got it in for the Comets. And the kick is up, and this one splits the uprights, and it is good. So it is 28-7. Wes Carter leads here with 10 minutes and 12 seconds left to play in the first half. We'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region and 2A Football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Time goes by. Don't forget to capture the moments that will create memories that will last a lifetime with Eastern Wing Photography. No matter the occasion, we have you covered. If you need family portraits, engagement photos, prom pictures, senior photos, sports photos, baby pictures, and wedding photos, we are ready to work for you. You can find us online on Facebook or contact us at 606-286-0991 or at easternlinkphotography@yahoo.com to schedule a photo session.
Come visit Stylish Stitches at our new home at 730 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard in Olive Hill, Kentucky, now with the Red Door Boutique, for the best in customized gifts and fashion, as well as local sports team merchandise. From the runway to game day, we have you covered.
All righty, back here at Wes Carter once again, where Wes Carter leads the Wildcats by 21. It is 28-7. Wes Carter picking up two rushing touchdowns and two passing touchdowns here in the first half. Has kind of been showing their universal side to them here tonight.
This Duval Moore kickoff.
So Bond ready to kick off again. This is going to be returned by number four as he makes it to about the 30-yard line. So that's Cameron Allen on the return. And so it will be first and 10 for Bath County.
By number nine.
And they're going to be on their own 30-yard line. So to start things off, the Wildcats got a little bit of an uphill battle here, but they have broken off for some long plays here tonight.
brought down by number 8, Caden Wilson.
So back from the shotgun, Easton for the Wildcats gets it and hands it off to number 11, and he's going to pick up maybe about 3 on the play. And so that's Carter Hart on the run for Bath County up the middle, and so that will be 2nd down and 7 here for the Wildcats.
Carter Hart, he was brought down by number 34, Connor Green. Gain of about 2 yards on the play brings up 2nd and 8.
As I get it actually to the 32, so it is going to be 2nd down and 8 here for Bath County. As Bath County spreading off, 2 wide receivers on the near side, 1 on the far side, tight end. Easton dropping back, looking to pass, rolls out. And tried to hit his man. Right around the 45-yard line, I believe that was intended for Butcher.
Butcher is incomplete.
But that is incomplete, so it will be 3rd down and 8 for Bath County.
From their own 32.
So try to get it down to Butcher down the field. That would have been a 1st down for Bath County. But comes up incomplete. So Bath County spreading out the field once again. Looking across the middle of the field, and that is going to be incomplete as he was trying to get that to Butcher once again across the middle of the field. And so that's going to be bringing up 4th down and 8 here for Bath County. So Owen St. John back to punt here for Bath County. And Jackson Bond set to receive here for the Comets.
Jackson Bond's back to receive.
There's the snap. And there's the kick. Going to go right to about the 50-yard line. Takes a Comet bounce finally before being touched by Bath County. And so that will be about the 48-yard line. So the Comet's going to have a good field position to start out this possession as they are on the Wildcat 49-yard line. Or 48-yard line, excuse me.
On the 16-yard punt.
So they said 16 yards on the punt for St. John.
From the Wildcat, 48.
So Wes Carter coming in again. 2 wide receivers on the near side, 2 on the far side. Been most of their format for the night. Hands it off to Crampton as he tries to squeeze up the middle. And he is going to pick up some good yardage. Gets into
Crampton with the carry.
About the 43-yard line.
Brought down by number 12, Butcher.
And so that's going to be 2nd down. And
6 yards on the play. It brings up 2nd and 4th.
For the Comets.
The Wildcat, 43.
So gets it up to right around the 43-yard line. It may be about 2nd and 5, a little bit more like it there. As he picks up, Crampton picks up 5 yards on the run. Man in motion, that's Blake McGlone. Fakes off the handoff, going deep down the field, and he has got it to number 8. And that is going to be another Comet touchdown, as that one was to Caden Wilson. And so a 43-yard touchdown for the Comets, and that's going to make it 34-7 here at Wes Carter. And so Wes Carter getting another passing touchdown and another long touchdown, 43 yards on the connection from East Step to Wilson. As they fake the handoff to Crampton up the as they tempting him going up the middle. But Wilson had a step on the Bath County cornerback and had it the rest of the way. So it is 43-7 here with 8:07 left to play here in the first half. Estep kicks this one, and that's going to split the uprights once again. So it is 35-7 here with 8:07 left to go in the first half. You're watching Manta Sports Media, and we'll be back here momentarily on the Manta Sports Media Network.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky, phone number 606-286-2692.
And back here for the kickoff, Isaac Bond ready to kick it off for the Comets. Looks like Sorrell and Everman back to receive for the Wildcats. Allen's been getting most of the action here this evening as he's going to call fair catch on the 30-yard line. And so that'll be first down and 10 for Bath County on the their own 30-yard line.
Allen with the catch. Brings up first and 10 for the Wildcats.
So Wes Carter putting on some pressure on the defensive side, getting
first and 10 for
Easton to throw the ball a little bit more than typically what they're used to. Of course, Bath County typically will start punching it up the middle here before too long, trying to beat down the defensive line. And this time Easton's going to roll out, and he has got his man as he made the connection there to Derek Butcher. But that picks up about a one-yard gain, and so that takes up to about the 31-yard line. And so that'll be second down and nine here for Bath County.
Direction 31.
So they're on the 31-yard line. Bath County getting some passes complete here, but most of them have been short. Their longest run of the afternoon or evening, and this is going to be a timeout to Bath County.
Timeout on the field.
That'll be their second charge timeout. They'll have one more left here in this half. So we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 2A football live here on the Manta Sports Media Network.
She made the cage.
If you've ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell. For the area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
It is second and nine for Bath County. They trail the Comets here 35-7. Gets his man. Oh, and that is in and out of the hands there as his intended receiver was Jack Wilson. And he had it in his hands, and that would have been a first down for Bath County, but just bobbled it ever so slightly and ends up dropping it. And so it's going to be a third and nine. Here for Bath County. That was a good pass there by Easton. Had it right there to Wilson. But just doubted himself just a moment. Of course, Blake McGlone was right there ready to make the tackle. Wildcat spreading out the field again. Fakes the handoff, drops back, gets his man on the side as he connects there to number one, Jordan Everman. And that's going to be good for about a 2-yard pickup. And so that will be fourth down territory, fourth down and seven here for Bath County. And so it looks like St. John is back out again to punt here for Bath County. Low snap finally gets this off. Bounces right around the 45. Jackson Bond touches it and then has to fall on it. He gets it right around the 42-yard line. So maybe a pickup of two on the return. But the ball took a little bit of a weird hop, and he had to thought he was going to pick it up, but ended up having to drop it there.
First and 10, Wes Carter.
So it's 6 minutes and 30 seconds left to play here in the opening half. We're still at 35-7.
From their own 42-yard line.
There's the snap, hands it off to Cole Crampton, and he may have lost just a little bit.
Crampton on the carry.
As we're going to get a timeout here, officials timeout.
No gain on the play, brings up a second and 10 for the Comets.
As officially no gain on the play, as it's still on the 42-yard line, so it'll be second and 10 here for the Comets. This time, isolating Jackson Bond on the near side. Two backs for Wes Carter on this play. Fakes the handoff, drops back, and tries to get it over to number five, Crampton, out on the flats. And that's going to be an incomplete pass. So that's going to be bringing up third down and 10 here for the Comets.
Crampton is incomplete.
As he faked the handoff to Crampton, and then Crampton shot out, tried to get the little short screen pass in.
Third and 10 for the Comets from their own 42.
So it's third down and 10 here for Wes Carter. Putting Wilson on the far side, Bond on the near side. Two tight ends. As he drops back, and this pass is going to be tipped. And they're going to say it's an incomplete pass. But that was tipped, I believe, by number 71 of Bath County. That'd be Diego McCrown. As he came in charging after Estep, and Estep trying to get rid of it. And that pass was tipped, but incomplete. And so that's going to be bringing up fourth and 10 here for Wes Carter. And so Wes Carter probably going to have to punt in this situation. As Isaac Bond is back Bond to punt for the Comets. And you've got Everman and Sorrell back to receive here for
Everman
the Wildcats.
Back to receive, along with Sorrell.
Of course, Wes Carter has done some trick plays this year, but this time actually gets it to Bond. Good punt on the way. Fair catch is going to be taken right around the 28-yard line.
Sorrell with the catch.
So fair catch there by Sorrell.
First and 10.
And it'll be first and 10 here for Bath County
for the Wildcats
on their own Actually, I think they backed it up a little bit. Took it to the 27. I thought it was on the 28, but it was on the 27-yard line there for Bath County. So at 5 minutes and 40 seconds, I'm sure Bath County anxious to try to get the ball up the field, having several three and outs here this evening. And quickly going to be wrapped up as I believe that one was sent out to Hart. It was, and Hart
with the carry,
losing about 3 yards on the play, gets it to about the 24. So that's going to be second down and 13 here for Bath County.
From the Wildcat 24-yard line.
So this time Easton coming back in, Hart coming out for Bath County. This time they got Lewis in the backfield under center. And Easton's going to roll out, and there's going to be a flag on the play as an incomplete pass. I believe that was intended, I think, for Otis.
Pass intended for Otis is incomplete.
But flag on the play.
We've got a flag on the play.
That was right around the 20-yard line. And looks like this is going to be holding against
the Wildcats.
Or maybe targeting. Or hit to the head. It's a personal foul. Personal foul is going to be declined, and it's going to be bringing up third down and 13. So it was a personal foul, I guess, hands to the face or hit to the helmet there of a Wes Carter defenseman. And so Wes Carter is going to decline that penalty. And so it will be third down and 13 here for the Wildcats. As this time Lewis coming off the field for Bath County. Two tight ends and a wide receiver there for Bath County. Looking to pass, and he has got his man right around the 30-yard line as Easton connects to Otis.
Otis is complete.
And so finally gets back in within the original line to gain, but looks like it's going to be fourth down and 8.
6 yards.
So about 5 yards on the gain on the pass from Easton to Otis. And looks like St. John is going to be back. Owen St. John going to be punting once again here for the Wildcats.
Kickoff for the punt.
And there's the punt. That one may have had a piece of it by the Comets. As flag on the play as it's finally stopped at the 45-yard line of the Wildcats. But flag in the backfield. And this is just going to be a sideline warning against the Wildcats. So no yardage lost. But the Comets will take over on their own, on the Wildcat 45-yard line.
Comets take over
with 3 minutes, 49 seconds left to play here in the first half.
Wildcat 45, be first and 10 for the Comets.
So Wes Carter putting three wide receivers on the far side, putting cramped them in motion, hitting them out on the flats, makes the connection. He's going to get about 7 yards on the play.
And so, on the carry.
They might put it about 6 yards on the play. So
about 6 yards.
So that'll be second down and four.
Second and four.
So they hit Crampton on the motion out in the flats, and he had a little bit of open room there, shook a few tackles, but is in there and picks up 6 for the Comets. E-step, this time's going to hand it off to Crampton. Crampton, nice spin move, and he's going to make it all the way to about the 28-yard line, or excuse me, the 31-yard line, excuse me, 31-yard line. And so that is going to be a first down for Wes Carter.
Brought to you by the Medicine Cabinet.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Comets off of the Crampton run.
Comets
had a nice little spin move.
From the Wildcat 31.
So 2 minutes, and we'll get our time adjusted here. It's 2 minutes, 32 seconds officially on the scoreboard. E-step with the snap, gets it to Bond on the short screen pass. And they're going to, and there's a flag down on the play.
Flag on the play.
And looks like this might be holding against the Comets.
Bond was complete.
And it's going to be face mask against Bath County. So that's going to be 15 yards, and then a
that penalty brought to you by the Hamilton
first down.
That brings up a new first and 10, Wes Carter.
So it'll be first down and 10 for Wes Carter.
Wildcat,
as it looks like it's on the 18 or 17, 18-yard line.
Folks, we need all the JFL players and middle school players to line up near the scoreboard.
So it's going to be
area.
Middle school and JFL night here this evening. As there's the snap by E-Step, catches McGlone on the side, but that pass is going to be incomplete. So that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Comets. As we're getting our time adjusted up here, 1:22 left to play here in the opening half.
The Comets brings up second and 10 from the 17.
And they're going to hand it off to Cole Crampton. As he's working his way outside, and he is punching his way in and dives for the pylon, and he is in for 6. That's another Cole Crampton and Wes Carter touchdown.
Cole Crampton, 17-yard run for a touchdown, Wes
so
Carter.
So Cole Crampton takes it 17 yards to the house. And that is going to be another Wes Carter touchdown, and it is now 41-7. Wes Carter on top. Of course, Wes Carter had a player, I think it was number 78, number 70. Jackson Kidwell took a little bit of a hard shot, but he's walking off the field underneath his own power. But he's got to come off here for a play. As E-Step is going to be set to kick the extra point here for the Comets.
E-Step out to attempt the extra point.
And the kick is up, and it is good. So Wes Carter, 42, Bath County 7, with a minute 14 left to play here in the opening half. We'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region Football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at chriswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell.
And back here, of course, Cole Crampton having a fantastic night there, adding on to his stats here this evening. But if you'd like to advertise with us, still plenty of spots available. Make sure you hit us up at MantisSportsMedia@gmail.com. Send us a message on here at Facebook, or you can call or text us at 606-207-3315. Love to hear from you. I'd love to make you part of the Mantis Sports Media family, and that way so you can get your business seen out here as well. And so we are back here once again. Wes Carter now 42, Bath County 7. And thank you, Kenny Bond, for those stars. That will definitely help out here as postseason nearing for a lot of sports out here late here in September. And that's going to be a fair catch taken once again by Cameron Allen.
That kickoff is brought to you by Duval and Moore Funeral Home.
And so if you haven't done so already, make sure that you do like our Facebook page and make sure to follow us. That way so you can catch all the greatest action here within the 16th region and Wes Carter and other surrounding local teams. And be sure to share the video out as well. We like to try to get our name out there as much as we can. We don't like to charge anybody for anything. So we want to bring this all this great coverage to you live out there as well. And so Bath County tightening up the format once again. Hands it off up toward the middle. And they're going to get a stoppage of forward progress right around the 35-yard line. So that's going to be about a 3-yard pickup. A lot of bodies around the way, so didn't see who was on the carry. But they did pick up three, so it's going to be second down and 7.
3 yards brings up 7, second and 7.
Of course, with under a minute left, this time Bath County pitches it out and to Quentin Lewis, and he's going to get knocked out of bounds right around the 38-yard line. So that's going to bring up third down here for Bath County with 33 seconds left to go here. So they're going to be on the 38-yard line. And so it'll be third and 4. So
third and 4 from the 38. The Wildcat 38.
And so once again, hands it off and it gets it up to around the 40. So that'll bring up fourth down. I believe that was Hart on the run once again for Bath County. And it's going to be fourth and 2, so a gain of 2 on the play. But Bath County not rushing to the line and under 10 seconds left to play here. So that may have been the last play of the first half. And it is. And so here at halftime,
at the end of the first half,
your score is Wes Carter 42, Bath County 7, and it has been the night of the long bomb and huge runs by both teams. Bath County's lone score on the night was a huge run taken there, a huge play taken by Bath County. And Wes Carter, of course, having some huge plays to add up on the scoreboard. Of course, like I said, we've mostly seen a defensive battle between Wes Carter and their opponents, but it seems like this evening Wes Carter getting those long plays out there, especially on the rush and passing, as they've had some huge plays off of the line of scrimmage. And so here momentarily as the officials clearing off here, it is JFL and middle school night here.
Ladies and gentlemen, field director pitches at the field. We're going to call out the JFL players first. We're going to start with our flag football team.
And hear the little ding there. And I'd like to thank Eric Rayburn for sending some stars out here this afternoon. Thank you. Definitely appreciate that as well. That will definitely go to help us provide some postseason coverage. And so here's the flag football, JFL.
Number 13, Bryant. Number 16, Cundiff. Number 12, Brazington. Number 22, Stevens. Number 23, Henderson. Number 35, Willoughby. Number 6, Eisen. Number 52, Fultz.
Nice little flip there.
Number 11, Stevens. Number 6, Cordell. Number 10, Dickerson. Number 57, Richmond. And number 25, Kissinger. That is our flag football team.
That is the flag football team.
Brandon Cundiff and Brent Cordell. And now for the second and third grade, their coaches are John Crow, Elmo Tackett, and Zach
Now for second and third grade JFL.
Number 14, Bailey. Number 9, Lowe. Number 34, Lee. Number 21, Crow. Number 35, Lyles. Number 3, Tackett. Number 80, Crow. Number 13, Crow. Number 72, Stevens. Number 14, Stevens. Number 8, McGuire. Number 78, Gerald. Number 70, Jordan. Number 10, Hansall. Number 30, Perry. Number 52, Fultz. Number 78, Bowling. Number 00, Payton. Number 30, Davis. Number 29, Lowe. Number 20, Flannery. Number 25, G. Number 1, Skaggs. Number 5, Witt. Number 47, Sammons. Number 38, Mayers. Number 76, Ham. Number 22, Cecil. Number 5, Hall. Number 57, Rowe. And we have one without a number, Roar. This is your second and third grade JFL players. Next up is the fourth grade. They are coached by P.A. Richards, Mike Skinner, and Johnny Napier. Number 00, Cottle. Number 3, Rayburn. Number 4, Skinner. Number 5, Hall. Number 6, Walton. Number 9, Napier. Number 10, Davis. Number 12, Ratliff. Number 13, Rowe. Number 20, Richards. Number 21, Miller. Number 22, English. Number 26, Norris. Number 25, Stamper. Number 53, Walton. Number 57, Ramey. Number 63, Henshaw. And another number, no number present, Roar. That is your fourth grade JFL. Fifth grade JFL. Number 12, Stamper. Number 13, Brazington. Number 1, English. Number 77, Boggs. Number 60, Bailey. Number 99, Manning. Number 78, Jordan. Number 23, Henderson. Number 75, Tackett. Number 50, Barker. Number 51, Sexton. Number 36, Barker. Number 86, Hildreth. And number 25, Big E. Their coaches are Zach Brezington, Chris Barker, Darren Barker. That is your fifth grade JFL. And now let's meet the middle school team. Their coaches are Jeremy Kennel, Nicholas Hayes, and Brayton Mays. Number 2, Hayden Hall.
And here's the middle school team.
Number 3, Nathan Flannery. Number 5, Caden Hedge. Number 8, Tabor Tackett. Number 10, Landon Callahan. Number 11, Luke Dean. Number 12, Carter Hall. Number 20, Caden Thompson. Number 22, Peyton Walker. Number 23, Dalton Carpenter. Number 28, Malik Wells. Number 33, Ethan Swearingen. Number 40, Mason Skidmore. Number 44, Craig Goodman. Number 50, Caleb Lawhorn. Number 51, Dylan Stigall. Number 52, Sawyer Maggard. Number 54, Griffith Rayburn. Number 58, Gunnar Jordan. Number 60, Ellis Kidwell. Number 62, Warren Duncan. Number 67, Will Cottle. Number 68, D'Angelo Allen. Number 70, Taylor Jordan. Number 73, Moses Oppenheimer. Number 74, Braden Reynolds. Number 76, Sebastian Dean. Number 77, Lucas Davis. Number 78, Alex Rayburn. Number 80, Sebastian Crow. Number 82, Wyatt Martin. Number 84, Blake McGlone. And number 88, Hunter Brunt. This is your West Carter Middle School Comets. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give all these kids.
And there's the West Carter Middle School Comets, and all these are the future Comets here. As we see both the JFL, the Junior Football League, as well as the Middle School Comets out here this evening. So let's take a quick look at halftime stats before we take a brief commercial break. What a game it has been out there. Of course, here at the half, West Carter is currently 12 or 7 of 12 on passing here this evening. For a total of 192 yards. They rushed the ball 11 times for a total of 157 yards. And West Carter has put up an amazing 349 yards in this opening half. Taking a look at Bath County, they are 6 of 11. So hanging right in there passing-wise with the Comets, but only for a total of 51 yards in passing. They've rushed the ball a total of 17 times for a total of 71 yards and has picked up 122 total yards on the evening. No turnovers just of yet. As far as penalty goes, of course, while the Bath County Wildcats are being plagued by those this evening as they have five penalties for a total of 50 yards here on the night, while West Carter has one penalty for a total of 15 yards. And, of course, that number of 50 yards could have probably been definitely increased if the Comets would have accepted a few more of the penalties. With having this score at the moment, they're not wanting to add insult to injury at the moment. you know, and push them back even further. As far as first downs, of course, that is a little bit of a typo. Let me get that corrected there, as Bath County just has a total of 3 first downs. Let's get that corrected there. Bath County has a total of 3 first downs, while West Carter has picked up 13 first downs here on the evening. And, of course, that gives us to our score of 42-7. Taking a look at some individual rushing now for the Comets. Cole Crampton, he's rushed the ball 11 times today for a total of 157 yards, and he's got 3 touchdowns here on the evening. And so Cole Crampton having a fantastic night here tonight as he is leading all Comet rushers with 157 yards. Then taking a look as well here for Bath County. Of course, taking a look, number 11, Carter Hart has rushed the ball 7 times for a total of 10 yards. And then their leading rusher, Quentin Lewis, has rushed the ball 6 times for a total of 64 yards. And he has the lone Bath County touchdown here tonight as he got a 53-yard rushing touchdown here against the Comets. And so that's Bath County's only score here on the night. But that was a 53-yard long rush for Quentin Lewis. And then, of course, Jacob Easton, the quarterback, has kept the ball 3 times for a total of a negative 3 yards. And so that's your halftime stats here this evening. And so we'll come back here momentarily as we take a brief commercial break. The teams are getting out and starting to stretch out here. Still about 2 minutes and 15 seconds before the 3-minute warm-up period. You are watching 2A football and District 8 matchup here live on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky, phone number 606-286-2692.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell. For the area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
And we're here back here at Blankenship Field. We're about 3 minutes away from the stretching time and the opening kickoff for the second half. Wes Carter did win the coin toss and did elect to defer, and so they will get the ball to start off here the second half. Taking a look, thank you, Amanda Reyna, for sharing this video out as well. Glad to see Patty and Gary Butcher out watching here this evening. And then Dudley Witt, thank you for tuning in here today, cheering on Derek Butcher and the Bath County Cats. And Amanda Rainia, once again, cheering on the Bath County Cats. Good to see Connie Hicks out there watching this evening, as well as Kayla Lowe Stafford. and Rita Bond. Thank you for tuning in here today, as well as Connie Hicks. Alan Conley, good to see you there watching this West Carter game, and Sonia Barker. And then, like I said, once again, thank you to Kenny Bond for sending out some stars here this evening. That is definitely appreciated, and good to see Peggy Lindell out as well. And thank you, Eric Rayburn, for the stars once again here. Good to see Jonathan Schwab out watching today, as well as David Graber. And yes, that is Chris Perry on the PA tonight, watching out from Mansville, Ohio. And then Jessica Salyer-Lettingham cheering on number nine, Brent King, and the Comets. And Jacob Schuler, once again, watching for the Comets here this afternoon. And so we're just about moments away as the stretching time just about over here. And like I said, make sure if you haven't done so already, make sure that you like our page. Make sure you follow us, and that way so that you never miss a moment of 16th Region sports action. Glad to be able to bring this to you here tonight. And, of course, Wes Carter, as we mentioned, will be getting the ball to start out the second half, as it is 42-7 here heading into it. And so Bath County's got a little bit of a long road ahead of them as they've played hard all night and had some great plays. Had that fantastic 53-yard run there by Quentin Lewis for their touchdown. And it just seems like things haven't been rolling together for the Bath County Wildcats here tonight. While Wes Carter has seemed like they've been breaking out, they've been saving all the long plays for this game, as they have had some huge runs here tonight. As we said, Cole Crampton has three touchdowns here today. And his touchdowns, of course, he had a 5-yard touchdown. That was his third rush, and then had a 1-yard touchdown, and then had a 17-yard touchdown. And that's his three touchdowns on the day. But most of their longer plays have come in from the air. And so Bath County getting ready to kick things off here. As there's the horn and everybody's getting ready, and it's going to look like back for Wes Carter. We've got number eight, Caden Wilson, as well as Jackson Bond out there to receive for the Comets. Of course, then you've got Blake McGlone up near side, and I believe Cole Crampton's on the far side over there. I believe that's him for the Comets. And then, of course, for Bath County getting ready to kick off here. And it looks like this is going to be St. John once again, or excuse me, number eight, Stegall for Bath County. As a little bit of a pooch kick there, and that one's taken by McGlone. And so that's going to be a fair catch for the Comets. And they are going to be taking on, or taking over on their own 37-yard line. And thank you, David Graber, for those stars out there. Definitely will help out here, especially coming in near to the postseason, as, of course, we're now into district play for here for West Carter. Of course, soccer next week, we're going to have to take a look and see, because it's going to be hosted at Greenup County, and I believe the girls' soccer team is going to be taking on Morgan County, while the boys soccer team, I believe, is drawing Greenup County. So Wes Carter has a man in motion, hands it off to Cole Crampton, and he is down behind the line of scrimmage as he
Crampton on the carry.
Was trying to break free, had a shoestring tackle. There by Carter Hart, but he's going to fall back about 3 yards, and so it'll be second down and 13.
3 yards on the play, brings up second and 13. And
so Wes Carter packing that 34. Far side of the field over there with their wide receivers, and try to run a blocking on there, but Hart snuck through on the secondary for Bath County. Man in motion again, that's Bond. High snap. Gets it to Bond on the flats. And he's still on his feet as he's going to get a first down. And then he is off to the races there as it is going to be 10-5. Touchdown West Carter as he heads into the tunnel. And so that is going to be another West Carter touchdown here this evening.
Pass to Bond for a 66-yard
So a 66-yard touchdown, and that was originally thrown behind the line of scrimmage. And so that was a backwards pass from Estep to Bond, and Bond just charged it all the rest of the way up the field for a 60-plus yard pass reception. And so West Carter now on top 48-7. And it looks like Estep's going to be out to kick once again here for the Comets for the extra point. So, once again, another huge play by the Comets. 67 yards on the play. And the kick is up. And this one's going to split the uprights, and it is in. So, Comets on top by 42. It is 49-7. Bath County will be getting the ball here here momentarily. So, we'll be back here in just a few moments here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
The area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports. Come visit Stylish Stitches at our new home at 730 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard in Olive Hill, Kentucky, now with the Red Door Boutique, for the best in customized gifts and fashion, as well as local sports team merchandise. From the runway to game day, we have you covered.
All righty, back here at West Carter once again, where West Carter took 1 minute and two plays to get the ball down 67 yards for the touchdown. So with 11 minutes left to go here in the third quarter, it's West Carter 49, Bath County 7. Isaac Vaughn set to kick it off for West Carter. Everman and Sorrell back to receive for the Wildcats. And this one's going to head to number 4 as he has got a little bit of running room and finally wrapped up and brought down at the Comet 45-yard line. So that is a good return there by Cameron Allen for the Wildcats, as that was about a, I think, about a 25-yard return for Bath County.
So the Wildcats.
So it'll be first and 10 here for Bath County.
From the Comet 45.
And if I'm not mistaken, I think we are underneath rolling clock rules here this evening. So it'll be first and 10 for Bath County on the West Carter 45. Hands it off up toward the middle. And he's going to get back to the line of scrimmage, as I think that was number 24, Quentin Lewis, gets back to the line of scrimmage, and so it'll be second down and 10 here for
Lewis
Bath County.
Carry, no gain on the play, brings up second and 10 from the 45.
So Bath County splitting out the field again, two on the far side, two on the near side. West Carter starting to head back deep as Easton drops back, but he's got a man open in number 1. And he's going to be thrown down by Sam Jones. And so that pass was good to Jordan Everman by Jacob Easton. And so that's going to pick up about 5 yards on the play. And so that'll be third down and 5 here for the Wildcats.
5 yard gain on the play brings up third and 5.
Yeah, Sam Jones on the tackle for the Comets. This time Hart's in the backfield for Bath County. Four wide receivers. Easton fakes the handoff, gets it a short pass to number 14, and he's going to get across for a first down. So that pass is complete to Zachary Otis, and that's going to be a first down here for the Bath County Wildcats, and it'll be first and 10 right at the 34-yard line.
From the Comet 34.
So as we said, rolling clock going on. So after 40-point separation between that, the clock will roll on for the rest of the night. As Easton drops back, had a Comet chasing him, but gets his man once again to number one. Still on his feet and makes it down to about the 18-yard line. So that pass good to Jordan Everman, and it will be another Bath County first down.
Enough for the first down. Brings up first and 10.
So first and 10 on the Wes Carter 18-yard line.
18-yard line.
So the first time that Bath County has been in the Wes Carter red zone here this evening. As their lone play was to get into the end zone was 53 yards. As Easton drops the ball, picks it back up, and he is going to be chased down by multiple Comets. He gets past the line of scrimmage, and so on the run, he may have picked up maybe Easton about a foot or so, but it'll be second down here for Bath County.
Neil Lusher with the tackle.
So had a lot of Comets out there. They're going to credit Lusher with the tackle.
Not much of a gain on the play.
And like I said, maybe picked up about a foot or so, getting closer to the 17-yard line.
17.
So it'll be second down here. Easton going to throw it downfield, and that is going to be I'm sure that's going to be pass interference against the Comets. So this is going to be a good field position here for the Wildcats, as that was thrown right at the goal line. The intended receiver was Jordan Everman, and that is pass interference, and so that'll be first down and goal here. Let's see where they spot the ball at, but it should be first and goal for Bath County. As it's right in around the 9-yard line. We're actually going to say it's second and one on the field. Throws it in there, and that is going to be intercepted there by, I think that is Bond. And he is off to the races here. He's only got the quarterback left to beat. Flag down on the play. And he's brought down finally before the end zone. But it's going to be an interception and multiple flags out on the field.
With the interception. But we've got a flag on the play.
So we got two flags all the way back here around the 44-yard line. And let's see what the officials are going to call this here, as that got it down in too deep into Comet territory right in the red zone. But I'm sure this one is probably going to be coming back, as it's going to be personal foul against the Comets. And so it'll be first down, and so the interception will count for Wes Carter. As this is going to be a spot foul, and so like I said, it was around the 43 originally, so this interception that was almost in for a touchdown is coming back to right around the 28-yard line.
15-yard penalty against the Comets. It'll be first and 10.
So it'll be first and 10 now for Wes Carter.
From 28.
As Easton got picked off on the side, I'm pretty sure that was Bond on the interception for Wes Carter. This time hands it off and is going to lose just a little bit.
Oppenheimer with the carry.
As that was number one, Cade Oppenheimer on the carry for the Comets. And so he's going to lose about 2 yards on the play. So it'll be second down and 12 here for the Comets.
From the Comet 26.
And so giving Crampton much-needed rest out there this evening as Oppenheimer back in the running back position, and he is off to the races now. Takes a hit and keeps on going as he gets all the way up to around the 35-yard line, near the 35-yard line, and that'll be a first down for Wes Carter on the Oppenheimer run.
Oppenheimer on the carry. 37-yard carry.
37-yard carry officially.
First and 10.
And so it'll be first down and 10 for Wes Carter on the Bath County 38-yard line. So Oppenheimer still staying out there again in the running back position.
From the Wildcat 38.
And they're going to hand it off to Oppenheimer again. He's going to fight through, pick up maybe one or two on the play. They'll bring up second down and about.
Oppenheimer on the carry.
Probably about
2 yards.
8 on the play.
Brings up second and 8.
So it'll be second down and 8. So it gets Oppenheimer gets 2 yards on the rush.
From the Wildcat 36.
As time continuing to run down. Here on the running clock, Oppenheimer still in the backfield for the Comets. Wes Carter's pulled most of their starters out there as they give it to Oppenheimer again. Cuts back, reverses field. He's got a couple men to meet, and he is in for the touchdown. So that is going to be another touchdown for Wes Carter. But there is a flag on the play. And we're going to see this one maybe coming back as it's going to be a false start or illegal formation against the Comets. So that play
second down
was a 36-yard run to the house for Oppenheimer, but flag on the play and legal procedure or legal formation by the Comets.
Wildcat 41.
And so that's going to back it up, and it'll be second down and 13 here for the Comets. So instead of 6 up on the board for Wes Carter, they're back 5 yards. This time putting in a tight formation. Reversing field as well. They've got number 3, Timothy Fields, on the far end of the field. Man in motion. Hands it off to Oppenheimer again. And he gets up to around the 45, but there is another flag on the play. And this one's going to go against the Comets again. So this is going to be a...
Brings up second and 18.
5-yard penalty for the Comets, and so it'll be second down and 18. But that's going to finish out the third quarter here. So Wes Carter is back second and 18 right now on their on the Bath County 46-yard line. And so we'll take a brief commercial break, and we'll be back here for fourth quarter action here live on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell. For the area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
And back here at Blankenship Field, where it is 49-7, running clock situation for Wes Carter. And so they are right now on their own, on the Bath County 46-yard line, and it will be second down and 18. Excuse me, second down and 18 here for Wes Carter. Hands it off to Oppenheimer again as he breaks a tackle, pushes all the way through up to the 40-yard line, and so that's going to be a third down and about 11, so about a 7-yard run by Oppenheimer. Or excuse me, that'll be third down and 12.
Gain of about 6 yards.
6-yard gain there by Kate Oppenheimer.
Third and 12. From the Wildcat 40-yard line.
So Oppenheimer about 8 yards back off of the ball, taking a deep position there. There's the snap, and they've got also a quarterback as well. That's Isaiah Bond on quarterback for Wes Carter. Hands it off to Oppenheimer again for a loss of about two.
And so on the carry. Loss is about 2 yards.
So that'll be fourth down and 14 here for the Comets. So Wes Carter putting in their second string, or actually I think second string for the Comets is actually McGlone, but they want to give him a little bit of a rest out there tonight as well. So they're going in to third string quarterback Isaiah Bond. And Wes Carter here with fourth and 14, getting the field, and they're going to go ahead and go with this on the short field. Not going to put out the punt team. Man in motion. Bond getting ready to take off with it, and he does. Has a man to beat there, but depends on the spot of the
Isaiah Bond with the keeper.
Because Isaiah Bond with the keeper gets to the 29-yard line. And that's going to be just about a yard short. And so that's going to be a turnover on downs by the Comets. And so it will be Bath County time, or Bath County,
will take over
offensive.
On downs, it'll be first and 10.
All right, so Bath County gets the defensive 30. Stop. Just barely catching Bond before crossing over in first down territory. He's about a yard short. And so we got a timeout here on the field.
Isaiah Bond with a 13-yard run.
So Bond officially with a 13-yard run here, but just needed 14. And so impromptu timeout here, and we'll take a brief commercial break, and we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region and 2A Football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank.
Next time you're in Mount Sterling, take the short drive out to Cecilia's Country Market at 4100 Maysville Road for some good home cooking, one of the area's best breakfast, and daily lunch specials, all at affordable prices. Competitive gas and diesel prices, with the little items we all need every day, all in one place.
Open from 8 a.m. until 7 p.m. That's Cecilia's Country Market, 4100 Maysville Road, Mount Sterling, Kentucky, right next to the world-famous Judy Drive-In.
Okay, back here, coming out of the officials' timeout. I did not see a signal one way or another for that, but both teams headed to the sideline, took a little bit of a break there, and so it is now first and 10 for the Bath County Wildcats right now on their own 30-yard line. Easton's dropping back and tries to get it to 14, Otis. But that is going to be incomplete, so it'll be second down and 10 here for the Wildcats.
From the 30.
So second and 10 for the Wildcats. Still on their own 30-yard line. Sure, they would like to get another score on the board. As Easton dropping off, gets it to Otis, number 14. He's got a first down and then some as he is off to the races. And he is going to be in for six. And that is going to be a Bath County touchdown. 70 yards from Easton to Otis, and that is going to be in for six for Bath County.
For the touchdown, Bath County.
So nice play there to get the long distance pass there, 70 yards on the play from Easton to Otis, and Bath County now is trailing the Comets 49-13. As looks like Bryson Stigall on the out to kick the extra point here for Bath County, with Easton going to hold.
Stigall's out for the kick.
And they fake it, and they're going to roll it off over to the side. And that is going to be a two-point conversion as fake kick pitches it out to Cameron Allen. And so Bath County picks up the two-point conversion, and it is now 49-15. Wes Carter still on top with about 8 minutes and 17 seconds left to play here in the ball game. And so we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 2A football live here on the Mantis Sports Media Network.
Time goes by. Don't forget to capture the moments that will create memories that will last a lifetime with Eastern Wing Photography. No matter the occasion, we have you covered. If you need family portraits, engagement photos, prom pictures, senior photos, sports photos, baby pictures, and wedding photos, we are ready to work for you. You can find us online on Facebook or contact us at 606-286-0991 or at easternwingphotography@yahoo.com to schedule a photo session.
Come visit Stylish Stitches at our new home at 730 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard in Olive Hill, Kentucky, now with the Red Door Boutique, for the best in customized gifts and fashion, as well as local sports team merchandise. From the runway to game day, we have you covered.
All righty, we're back here at Wes Carter, where Bryson Stigall is on the to kick off for Wes Carter. Jackson Bond and looks like Caden Wilson back to receive for the Comets. Good kickoff this time. It's going to make it over to Wilson right around the 15-yard line. And he is finally brought down right around the 48-yard line. So, good return.
Caden
about
proceed to kickoff.
Is right around the 15-yard line, I believe, and so gets it up to around the 49-yard line. So about a 34-yard return.
First and 10, Wes Carter.
And so it'll be a first down for Wes Carter on their own 49-yard line.
From the Comet 49-yard line.
So a good return there by Wilson. So first and 10 here for Wes Carter, 7:25 left to play here in the game. Still rolling clock. And looks like they've got number 17 out there, Kale back. And we're going to get a timeout taken here by the Comets. That'll be their first timeout, so we'll take a brief commercial break and we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching 16th Region Football live here on Mantis Sports Media.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky. Phone number 606-286-2692.
So Kale back, freshman in for Wes Carter at quarterback. Hands this off to number 7, and he is off to the races himself. And finally, he's got himself a first down as he gets it around. I thought it was 7, but it's 1, Oppenheimer. And so he gets it into Bath County territory, gets it right around the 34-yard line. And so that'll be first and 10 for Wes Carter now on the Bath County 34-yard line. As I mentioned, Kale back. First time we've seen him this season at the helm for the Comets. Hands it off to Oppenheimer, I believe, once again. See, it's going to pick up about one on the play.
Gain of about 1 yard.
And so that'll be second down and 9 here for Wes Carter.
The Wildcat 33.
And so we're going to get a timeout taken here by Bath County. That'll be their first timeout here of the second half. And so we'll be back here momentarily. You're watching football action live here on Mantis Sports Media.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 110,000 participants here in Kentucky who take part in high school sports.
And hand off to Oppenheimer again, and he's going to be stopping with forward progress as he gets about 4 yards on the play.
Oppenheimer on the carry.
I'll be bringing up third down and about Bunch 5 here for Wes stop. Carter.
Brings up third down. Gain of about 3 yards. Brings up third and 6 for the Comets from the Wildcat.
So. 30. Third down, and actually they're going to give him just a yard less there, and so it'll be third down and 6 here for Wes Carter. Oppenheimer back in the backfield. Wes Carter with multiple tight ends. And pitches this one to Oppenheimer. as he rolls out to his left and gets it to about the 29-yard line. Pick up of about one on the play.
Easton
on the tackle for Bath County. And so
about 1 yard.
That will be fourth down and five here for the Comets. Of course, with time dwindling down, it gives both these teams a little chance to try out a few things. As Wes Carter, of course, going down there to their bench. Of course, Oppenheimer, a junior, mostly plays in the defensive safety position and backup running back, but getting several reps here late here in the fourth quarter. As Tom, they're going to let him pass, throws it across the field, and he has got his man for a first down. And I think that was to Landon, that was number three, Timothy Fields.
Fields is good. It's enough for a first down.
So back in his first pass here this afternoon or this evening, gets it to Timmy Fields for a first down.
First and 10 for the Comets from the Wildcat 28.
So now from the Wildcat 28, the first and 10 here for the Comets. Hands it off to Oppenheimer again as he shakes through a nice little cut. And he's going to get up.
On the carry.
He's going to get up about almost looks like maybe 7 yards on the play. Gets it up to around the 12-yard line.
6 yard pickup.
Or 6 yards, I should say. So it'll be second and four here for the Comets off of the Oppenheimer run.
12.
So Wes Carter now in the red zone here late in this fourth quarter. And they're going to hand it off to Oppenheimer again as he cuts through, rolls, and he's going to pick up a first down. And he's going to be right around the 2-yard line.
First down, Wes Carter.
So that'll be first and goal here for Wes Carter. Still 2 minutes, 9 seconds left to play. All right, it's going to be on the 3-yard line, so it'll be first and goal from the 3-yard line.
First and goal for the Comets from the.
And we're going to get a timeout here.
Three.
Yeah, I think this one's going to be taken possibly maybe a 30-second here by the Comets as trying to get some different personnel in. So they do get some different personnel in. Of course, back still in for Wes Carter. Looks like number 20 is out there in the backfield, Braden DeHart. As they hand the ball off to him, and he is quickly tied up by number 5, Owen St. John of Bath County. And that'll be second and goal for the Comets.
Dean on the carry.
All right, they said it was Dean on the carry. Dwaylen Dean on the carry for Wes Carter.
Second down.
So actually bumps it back to about the 5, as we are under a minute now left to play here. Oppenheimer back in position for the Comets. And cuts through, flag on the play, he's going to be just short. And this one's going to go against Bath County, personal foul. And so that's going to be underneath 40 seconds. And so that is going to finish things off here. And so your final score here from Wes Carter is 49 and Bath County 15. And so we'll take a brief, we'll keep it here until the end of the time there. But it has been a game of huge gains and huge plays by both teams. You know, it seems like with the exception of the run-in by Cole Crampton, which that was under 10 yards, every other play was huge, either bomb pass or a long run. And so that's going to finish things out here. So your final score is Wes Carter 49, Bath County 15. We'll take a brief commercial break and come back with our final thoughts here here at Wes Carter. So your final score once again, 49, Wes Carter 15, Bath County.
Patrick Flannery proudly serves as the Kentucky State Representative for the 96th District and would like to thank the citizens of Carter and Lawrence counties for their continued support. He would also like to wish good luck to all of our area sports teams, and Patrick Flannery is a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Fall and winter just around the corner. Make sure your home is ready for the season with the help from the good people from James Do It Best Hardware. If you need to get your lawn ready or to trim a few trees before winter, we have you covered as an authorized steel dealer. And don't forget, Case Knives makes a great present any time of the year. James Do It Best Hardware, 137 Scott Street, Olive Hill, Kentucky, phone number 606-286-2692.
If you have ever been in an auto accident, it can be a very stressful and confusing time. So let Justin Criswell help you through the process to get what you deserve. The Criswell Law Office is here for all of your legal needs. Contact us at 606-474-0029 or visit our office at 142 East Main Street in Grayson, Kentucky, or online at criswell.attorney. And remember that all will be well with Justin Criswell.
For the area's best steak, burgers, fish, appetizers, and drinks, along with great live entertainment, games, and the big game on the big screen, head to Henry's at 530 East Tom T. Hall Boulevard. And as the days get shorter, don't let that tan fade away. Head to Beach Buns Tanning. With a location near you, you are never too far away from a great tan. Henry's and Beach Bun Tanning are proud supporters of local high school sports.
As time goes by, don't forget to capture the moments that will create memories that will last a lifetime. With Eastern Wing Photography, no matter the occasion, we have you covered. If you need family portraits, engagement photos, prom pictures, senior photos, sports photos, baby pictures, and wedding photos, we are ready to work for you. You can find us online on Facebook or contact us at 606-286-0991 or at easternwingphotography@yahoo.com to schedule a photo session.
Back here at Wes Carter once again, where Wes Carter improves up to 4-2 on the season. They are 2-2 in or 2-0 in Class 2A, and they are 2-0 in District 8. Bath County, they fall down to 3-4 on the season. And trying to get located there, they are 0-2 in Class 2A, and after tonight, they are 0-2 within District 2. So Wes Carter next week is going to be heading to Prestonsburg. So they're taking the long drive down the Country Music Highway to hit up on Prestonsburg next week before their final home game, which will be set on October 15th. And that's going to be against Martin County. And so just 4 more weeks left to go here in the football regular season as Wes Carter improving up As we mentioned on there, to 4-2 on the season, defeating the Bath County Wildcats 49-15 here tonight. Of course, next week, stay tuned onto our Manta Sports Media Facebook page as we'll try to bring you as many games as we possibly can out there. I know next week it's going to be postseason for the soccer teams, and taking a look at boys soccer. They're going to be playing Greenup County at Greenup County in the first round of the 62nd District Tournament, and that game is going to be set for 6 o'clock on October 5th. And then, of course, for the Lady Comets soccer team, they are going to be on the road to Greenup County again, and I believe they're going to be playing Morgan County in the tomorrow they're going to be playing Ashland Paul Blazer in their last home game of the season at 11 o'clock. Of course, that one was rescheduled back from the end of August. And so they'll have one last game before heading to Greenup County on October 5th for an 8 o'clock game with the Morgan County Cougars. Of course, Wes Carter defeating Morgan County earlier in the season. They defeated them 3-2 at a home match back in about mid-August. And then, of course, don't think they played them any more. No more the rest of the season. Tight game, 3-2 against Morgan County, and so they'll be playing them in the first round of the 62nd District. We'll have to take a look and see, because I know those games are going to be at Greenup County, and I think Greenup County is a National Federation Network member, and so we'll have to see what kind of media coverage we can provide for that 62nd District tournament there. Of course, volleyball is going to be on the road next week as well. So it seems like all of our Comet teams taking next week on the road as they're going to be going to Greenup County on the 5th. So if you're a Comet fan, head over to Greenup County. You can catch some volleyball or some soccer over there as they're going to be playing Greenup County at Greenup at 7 o'clock. That's West Carter volleyball. And then soccer is going to be at 6 and 8 o'clock for boys soccer at 6 and girls soccer at 8. And then the last game for the Lady Comets volleyball team is going to be October 12th as they're going to be taking on the Kittens of Ashland Paul Blazer. And then they're going to finish off their season on October 14th at Fleming County. And so just weeks away from the postseason for volleyball as the district tournament happening next week in soccer. And so we'll try to see what we can bring in coverage to you. Of course, keep in mind, just check our Facebook page. And that's where you can find out what games we're going to be covering or what games we can cover. For the next week, and we'll try to get that information to you as soon as we get it ourselves, because we have to check in with Greenup County to see if they allow other media to come in. And so that's going to finish us up here at Wes Carter, and I definitely like to thank all of our people here tonight. Thank you, David Graber, for sending some stars, as well as Eric Rayburn and Kenny Bond. Definitely appreciated, and you're very welcome for keeping up, keeping with us here today. And so that's going to finish us up here. And so for Jeff Irwin and the Manta Sports Media crew, thank you very much for tuning in. We'll post some stats up for the in-game stats here a little bit later on this week, and we'll try to get the football game posted up here shortly as well on our YouTube channel. Of course, unfortunately, right now we can't broadcast simultaneously on Facebook and YouTube for outdoor events off our cellular networks, but on indoors we can bring you coverage live both on Facebook and YouTube. So we'll get our YouTube feed of this here shortly as well. So for Jeff Irwin, the Manta Sports Media team, thank you very much for tuning in here today. God bless you all, and have a great rest of your Friday and good weekend as, of course, school's right around the corner here for Carter County Schools to get back in session next week. So remember to set those alarm clocks early on Sunday night for Sunday night going into Monday morning. So we'll see you all next time here, and just pay attention to our Facebook page for all of our broadcast schedule coming up for the next week. Thank you, and God bless you all, and we'll see you all again next time here on the Manta Sports Media Network.